thought process is to take that thought process of simplicity and apply it to your environment to give you great power in orchestrating your applications, because I can lower the total cost of ownership. I don't have to build a whole bunch of monitors on my own. I've got something already available to me in Control-M. I don't have to write the individual automation because I have application built integrations already in Control-M that directly interact with those tools. I have the ability to do some of these things agentlessly, where I don't have to put a piece of infrastructure out there and actually connect to a box to run a script or command. I can actually do it over SSH or WMI. I have the ability to do agent upgrades very, very quickly. So when we start thinking about that lower total cost of ownership, when we think about it from the application perspective, it really is about driving out of the application development process the need to create, test, and maintain the automation to run the work that you're building for the application. We also give good information about mean time to recovery, getting information about in that whole orchestrated process, what is my critical path, monitoring it actively, giving you information in a true single interface about what's going on, and giving it to you in such a way that it's easily digestible, not only by yourself, but by those people who are the stakeholders somewhere else in the business. And they can do it on the web, on their mobile device, very, very quickly. And you always will get detailed information about what's going on, whether it's how the job executed, how we're performing against our SLAs, or who did what to who. All of those types of things are available and encompassed in an application management platform such as Control-M that makes it a very simple thought process, but gives you great power in orchestration. And it is a proven technology. Proven, not by me, because I say so, but by Gartner. Dick had made mention that, you know, RightStar has been selected by Forrester as a leading consultancy in the IT community. Control-M, for the past 12 years, or the past six Gartner quadrants, has been the leader and the sole visionary for workload automation. This is the tool that everybody has been looking to be in any stretch, way, or need for workload automation. It's been the pinnacle. And now with the application management piece of it, the way we've interacted with the third-party applications that exist, the way we do things, we are even farther up in that quadrant now. This is the kind of tool that you're entertaining with this webinar. This is the kind of orchestration that you can leverage to make your applications even more efficient than they are today. Now, let's take a look at what that product actually looks like. This is Control-M. This is the management platform. When I look at my applications, I have the ability to see them in many, many forms. I have the application out here, and I'm reducing the boxes here so you can actually see the breadth and depth of this. Of all kinds of work, command work, database workload, data stage workload, file transfer workload, all the way down the line as one single application. So I know that I have 20 or 30 scripts I have to run. I know I have two or three or four Informatica jobs I have to run. I know that I have certain database processes I need to run, and these are how they are orchestrated. And again, it is object-oriented. So I have all of the objects up here in the upper left-hand corner where I can pick. I'm going to do a file transfer. I'm going to do a Cognos job. I'm going to do something in Oracle Business Intelligence. I'm going to run a web service. I'm going to go ahead and run a backup. I'm going to do a database job where I can do a database load or whatever I need to do as an object. And I drag that in here, and that's how all of these little boxes, and I'll zoom back into here so you can see them a little bit better, were formed. This is a command job, a job that actually runs a script or command. In this case, it's asleep. But the point being is that I have a definition of what I'm going to run. I have scheduling criteria to decide what days of the week I'm going to run on, and timing so I can decide what my times look like. And I can be cyclic, or I can actually say I want to run this job every 5 minutes for the next 24 hours and still have it counted as one unit of work inside of Control-M. I have the ability to decide what my prerequisites are, what conditions I wait for to start, what resources I wish to wait for before I execute. and the actions I take after the job completes successfully, what I set off downstream in the case of the out conditions, what notifications I send to people either before the job completes or after, and putting in what we call undo automation. On this situation occurring, do this action. And there are many types of actions you can take: loading new jobs, posting conditions, sending emails, sending alerts. All those things are part of this job definition. And the process of job definition is exactly the same, regardless of the type of work. So when I look at, for example, the difference between that script or command job and, for example, this Informatica job that I've got out here, really the only difference is here is what I'm actually running. In this case, I'm running a repository folder with a specific workflow. But all of the other things that I do are the same. I have the same scheduling criteria and timings. I have the same prerequisites. I have the same actions. So the process of orchestration becomes very predictable, very easy to create, because I don't have to think about all of the little specifics that are different between Informatica and Cognos and DataStage, or PeopleSoft and SAP and Oracle eBusiness, or Oracle as a database versus SQL Server as a database versus Sybase, for example. All of those things are made more transparent because of Control-M. And Control-M is built to be compliant to the application. So, for example, if I wanted to search out the repository folders under this Informatica, I can go ahead and hit that three-dotted button, and it will go out and ask Informatica for all of the repository folders that are available under that currently logged-in connection profile. So I can pick, you know, anyone that's here, Res, for example. If I wanted to go out and see what workflows were available out there, I can do that same three-dotted button. And all of the application, third-party application control modules that we build, these third-party application integrations, all have this capability. So I can go out and pick whichever types of things are already in there. I don't have to be the Informatica guy. I don't have to know anything about the Informatica backend to get this orchestration done. And I will be the first person to tell you, I know nothing about Informatica. I know nothing about DataStage. I know nothing about Oracle eBusiness, but I do know workload automation, and I know this tool can give me what I need to know. So if the person who wants me to create the orchestration gives me just that repository folder and workflow, I can go ahead and get it scheduled, but I don't have to go dig it out. The product will do it for me. This is the kind of thing that you have the ability to do. You store this in Control-M by checking it in. Once you do that, it becomes part of a schedule using all of that information that you gave it. So you told it to run on Friday at 4 in the afternoon, and it's cyclic, and it runs every 5 minutes. All of those things get loaded on Friday at that time, and it will start running. And you'll have the monitoring perspective, like you see here, to actually go see what's going on. And that can be extrapolated operationally to the individual entities, like you see here. So for example, if I wanted to fool around and take a look at that Informatica workflow, there it is. I have all of the information about that job's execution in front of me. I can actually see when it was supposed to be scheduled, its timing, its run information, what actually happened, when did it start, when did it end. And I don't even have to be double-clicking on that box, because if I single-click on it on the right-hand side, I get that same synopsis. So again, I'm trying to present more information to you, so when you're using this as an application management platform, that you get good information about what's going on. And then, of course, there's the ability to orient this to the individual high-level business process. It's what we call a business service, and you'll see a lot of them here in this list, like audit reporting and VF basic demo and SLS payroll daily and inventory deadline. This takes all of that job-by-job information and homogenizes it down to usable, actionable information. If I were to go ahead and type in my three letters here, you'll see these are all the services that are assigned to me, and I have one out here that's my demonstration service, the one that you've been looking at. And I can see that the service is late, that I have a job that has failed, and I can actually look on the right-hand side at the problematic jobs, and it will tell me what those are. I can see what my estimated time to completion is, what my deadline time is. If I have any slack time left, I can even look and be more detailed in the view to actually see not only the mix of jobs, their current states, but also their forecasted information as well. And I can present that to those people who need to know in a very simple way. I'm not the Control-M user anymore. I'm not that orchestration guy. I'm not you. I'm the application owner, the application manager, the guy who's responsible for inventory. And he can come to this dashboard and see anything he needs to see. And I can present it to him any way I need to present it to him. Whether I'm presenting it to him as a holistic monitor of the health and temper of a given application or breaking it down to the individual component parts, I have the ability to show them that very, very quickly. And they can double-click and drill into that information. They can actually see the jobs that actually are part of that business service. They can actually see how they're hooked together. And actually, if you want them to, give them the ability to take some kind of action, putting a job on hold, going ahead and releasing a job for execution, rerunning it. Those things can be given here if you want them to, but you don't have to. It can be a read-only interface. It can also be an order interface. For example, this is what the view looks like for an individual application. I still have the ability to see on my right-hand side all of the jobs and their executions. If I go ahead and highlight a job, it gives me the same information operationally that you would see as a regular application orchestration person, except now it's homogenized in a way that people understand, where I can actually see output, waiting info, statistics, all those types of things. And like I said before, you can turn this into an operational platform and order things. For example, I can create what we call an orderable service where I can actually go out, and let's say I'm using ADP for my auto pay, where I can actually say, you have the ability to ask for a series of work to be loaded. The work already exists. The process that you have orchestrated already exists in Control-M. And I can ask that user for information. What is the company name you're running the payroll reports for? What pay date are you looking for? And have them provide me with subject description information as to why you're making that request. And actually hit the order button and actually have it go out and order a bunch of jobs for you. So now not only can I do the regular orchestration of those things that have to be done every single day to make sure that the output of the application is in the formats it needs to be, but I can also do it for the ad hoc work, the stuff that you run once a quarter, once a month, when somebody needs it, whatever it happens to be, and they can come to an easily digestible interface and work with this kind of system. That's the kind of power that Control-M puts into your hands. And the benefits of those things are very, very palpable. You have the ability to go out and look at all of those things very, very succinctly. Let me go back over to my slide deck here. I apologize for doing that. For some reason, it doesn't want to do what I'm asking it to do. Go back down there. There we go. These are the benefits that you would derive from using Control-M in that thought process. Eliminating a lot of this back and forth between people, knowing how my SLAs are being managed and making sure I don't have any breaches, getting better information about root cause analysis for my applications and understanding where my problems are, understanding and reducing the need to create so many things, to actually take the onus off of you to create the automation and using Control-M to do that, and giving you good historical information so that you know when your SLAs have been missed, when jobs have been out of scope, if you're creeping past that consistently, making sure that if you're going to try and make sure that people understand that you're making your SLAs, to give them the ability to see that and also understand that that is an auditable process, that it is completely auditable, that I understand who did what to who and why. This is the kind of thing that Control-M puts in your hands. This is the kind of strength that you can place in your applications so that they're managed really, really well and in a very informed way, a very actionable way, and a very simple way.